Wheel cleaners come in a variety of options, ranging from the most aggressive type of wheel cleaner, commonly called chrome wheel cleaner. This is designed specifically for chrome-plated wheels. If you've got factory wheels, such as the vehicle we're working on here, that are clear-coated, we're going to recommend a product that's designed for all wheel and tires. They specifically work fantastic and are designed for these factory-coated silver wheels. However, if you've got aftermarket aluminum, aftermarket powder-coated, aftermarket anodized, you've got multi-piece wheels, or you've upgraded to specialized brake components, we highly recommend getting the least aggressive wheel cleaner that's offered, such as our Hot Rims aluminum wheel cleaner. This is guaranteed not to damage or etch any of those delicate surfaces that you may have on your vehicle. And when you're using any of these wheel cleaners on the proper type of wheel, it's also good to have a variety of wheel brushes that are going to help clean that wheel as well, such as a wheel spoke brush that's going to be able to get down into those spokes, or actually a quality wheel face brush that is soft enough not to damage, but still is going to be able to get in there and help agitate any of that stubborn brake dust to clean that wheel even quicker and faster. So upon inspection of this vehicle that we're going to clean today, we've noticed that it has factory coated wheels. We've noticed that there's no aftermarket suspension components. There's no delicate brake components that we need to worry about it. So we're going to be safe to grab our all-wheel and tire cleaner for this particular vehicle. Now we recommend spraying liberally from the bottom of the wheel up. And don't forget to thoroughly spray all those windows and lug nut areas to ensure you get good uniform cleaning action. Again, we're going to recommend taking a wheel face brush and come in here and help agitate. We're going to actually spray this tire as well to ensure it becomes clean. As you can see, that browning already coming off is old tire dressing, dirt, grime, and that's really important to make the new tire dressing that you're going to apply stick well, last longer, and not sling up the side of your car. To minimize any risk of damaging all four wheels, we're going to go ahead and rinse this wheel first, now that we've cleaned it with the proper wheel cleaner and use the appropriate brushes, before we move on and clean and rinse any of the other three wheels. Now that we've cleaned off four of these wheels and tires, they look good, all the brake dust, road grime is actually gone, it's time to go ahead and wash this car and finish it out. But remember, when choosing the right wheel cleaner, you have to understand what wheel you're working on, what type of brake components, what type of suspension components, and you're always going to want to choose the appropriate wheel cleaner, whether that's chrome, whether that's all wheel and tire, or whether that's an aluminum cleaner, to be the least aggressive method possible. And don't forget, always clean one wheel and tire at a time.